Hi everyone, I'm Lim Yi Wei. I am the Calon for Kerusi Dun Selangor N35 Kampung Tungku. I hope you guys know where Kampung Tungku is, but if you don't know, it's SS123 Sungai Wei Section 20-21-22 Petaling Jaya. Yeah. I grew up in Ipoh in a family of teachers. So my mom, dad, my grandmother and my aunt are all teachers. Somehow I ended up as a politician. I studied in Hong Kong, I did finance, and 2 years ago I decided to come back to Malaysia, so I resigned and joined the DAP. My parents call it a temporary lapse in sanity.
Wow. Yeah.
Apparently when I was about 4 years old and she was 2 years old, I poured rojak sauce on her. Yeah. I just took the bowl and apparently I just poured it over her. So I don't remember anything about it, but she says it happens. It happened. I think I mostly learned, the biggest lesson for me was to have empathy. Yeah, for people who are less fortunate. So my bapa was a discipline master in a pretty troubled school that got discipline problems in Ipoh. And he was the type who would walk around with the rotan, in his hand, ronda the school. And in the afternoons, he has to go down to the Balai Police quite often because the boys are fighting. But also that school was, in Ipoh, you have English debate teams and you have Class A and Class B. So Class B is not so good. And what my father did was he took a group of boys and girls and he really coached them. So in the end, they actually made it to Class A. Amid all this, gangsterism and students with family problems, I think my dad's drive to discover their potential really made an impact on me. And even now, sometimes when we go around, at the coffee shops in Ipoh, he bumps into his old students and they're like, "Oh, you changed my life, Mr. Lim." Funny mountain tofu pho is overrated. I think a lot of people are going to hate me for saying this. Best places to go for food. There is a Wai Sik Kai, like a Medan Selera, near SMJK Samtet at night. Yeah, that operates at night. Actually, Ipoh is full of good food compared to KL, I feel like. Yeah, the wantan mien and Kai Siok Fan chicken noodles are good. And there's a famous Chee Cheong Fan stall, a very small one in Canning Garden that people line up in cars to buy from. Yeah, she's been there for more than 10 years and she's still there. No, the youngest one right now is Prabhakaran, who's 22 years old and he's running in Batu. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the parliament seat of Batu, the one that Tian Chua got disqualified from. Okay. Yeah. I like sour and spicy food. And that balance in Asam Laksa, it's so appetizing. I like the pineapple inside. I don't really like the vegetables as much because I don't like timun, but I like the fish. Yeah. So I always like empty up the soup and leave the vegetables. 28, going to be 29. Mm. I used to go to the gym quite a lot when I was working back in Hong Kong. For me, I'm actually a very competitive person. So gym lifting weights gives me the space to lepas geram lah, that kind of thing, lepas some of that competitive spirit. I also enjoy cooking and reading a lot. But now my hobby is Pokemon Go because it keeps me walking around. So Damansara Utama has a lot of poker stops, so I'm always walking or driving around. I can make tom yum quite well. Mm-hmm. And also spare ribs, so barbecue ribs. Yeah. When I was in Hong Kong, I managed to menyaksikan the Umbrella Revolution, so a revolusi payung. And it was a very, a bit of earth-shaking moment for me because the revolusi payung was a gerakan mahasiswa and they were demanding for their right to vote in their own government. Because in Hong Kong, a lot of the filtering of candidates and all is very heavily influenced by business interests and also by mainland China. They vote quite differently from us. It's very limited. And it made me ask myself, why are Hong Kong students so mature in their understanding of democracy, and also why Malaysian youth seem to be a little bit behind. So I decided, you know, I'm young, I'm going to come back and try to learn everything that is about politics in Malaysia, and then see if, you know, I'm good enough at it and whether it's suitable for me and I can stay and contribute. I think the students in Hong Kong, Mahasiswa Kat Hong Kong, they are very fiercely proud of their Hong Kong identity. To be fair, lah, this is satu disclaimer. Lah. I mean, Hong Kong is majority like Chinese race, so it's also easier to be, you know, like pepaduan and all those, because you get past the racial issues, unlike in Malaysia, and you can focus on other things. But they are very proud of their Cantonese language, and the fact that they are different from Hong Kong. So they want to preserve that history, the unique history, and also the one country, two systems thing. So, for example, the leader of the Umbrella Revolution, Joshua Wong, he was 18 at the time of the revolution, but about 4 years before that, he actually led a protest against mainland China, trying to alter the Hong Kong history textbooks, the school textbooks, because they felt that it was whitewashing history. I think we need political education, or at least civic democratic education. We always say, you know, because kita lahir di negara ini, maka kita warga negara, and somehow from somewhere we are supposed to love the country, but we never really, you know, talk about why should people love a country, why should people be loyal to a country, and what are the rights you have as a citizen. Yeah, I think we need to understand that very well. So macam budak-budak kat America, they actually learn all this, you know, the American history and their Declaration of Rights in school. And so they know how government works, sangat berbeza dengan Malaysia. Like, for example, a lot of people think when I'm a counsellor, like Ali Majlis MBPJ, they think I'm a psychologist punya counsellor, like masalah counselling, you come to me. I'm actually a very introverted person, so I'm still learning as I go along. But now I lost my stage nerves lah. I had one ceramah after hari penamaan calon, and I was supposed to MC first, and then they said you need to speak like berceramah. And then I was like, mati lah, Chinese majority crowd, because I'm not good at Mandarin or Cantonese. But somehow I went up there and I said like certain buzzwords, and people were very supportive. I think I reached a point where, you know, like the macam madman theory, where, you know, you do something so crazy that nothing else really, nothing less than that scares you as much. But what I have done as a counselor masa jadi ahli majlis, I really realized also that problem, because we come into contact with a lot of young people and they have opinions, tapi mereka tak tahu macam mana nak express. So what we do is we have soft events lah, macam film screening. A lot of people come up to me more often. I think it's quite weird seeing my face everywhere and people like looking at me like, eh, macam tam cham tak cham, that kind of thing. But I think for me it's very important to stay grounded lah. I have more experienced friends who advise me, so when you become calon atau eventually if you win become YB, a lot of people will try to approach you. So I guess now that I'm a candidate, I am a bit more watchful of the people who come up to me. Not that I don't want to meet a lot of people, but that's the different part lah. Because last time, you know, you can just like jalan-jalan and tak ada orang kenal, you know, if I'm playing Pokemon Go, that kind of thing. But now, if people see me playing Pokemon Go, entah, they will think I'm cool, or like, you know, very wakil rakyat yang gila, that still playing children's games. I think for me, we've prepared for this, in the sense that pencalonan is very unpredictable. There are a lot of factors. But when I became ahli majlis, there were already like rumors, you know, oh, dia akan dikedepankan, and all, and it was something that in a way I worked for and prepared myself for mentally. Yeah, So I'm actually very calm about it. You know, every day I just take it as it goes, just try to know as many voters, understand their problems. I read horror stories on Reddit, you know, that forum bot r/no sleep, so that I can sleep. Yeah. Ada. Yeah, sorry guys.
Sorry everyone.
It's okay. You can try to kill him, I guess. I don't know. Okay. I think you have to gonna set boundaries. Definitely have to determine like when is a good time to not answer phone calls, when to take care of your family. Now also I'm learning lah, you know, semasa menjadi calon, I will try to rest as much as possible in between. For example, our daily schedule masa petang tak banyak lah untuk dilakukan. So we start off with the morning walkabout kat pasar pagi, and then maybe around the surrounding area. Lepas tu in the afternoon I sleep for at least like maybe 1 or 2 hours, and after that you know, do my other things, social media updates semua tu, and then after that come up to ceramah. So it's about really managing your time and just knowing when to turn off. That's the most important thing. For first time voters, tolonglah keluar mengundi. You need to exercise your right as citizens. Ini shameless plug lah untuk Pakatan Harapan. But I think kita semua sudah maklum bagaimana keadaan di bawah Kerajaan Barisan Nasional, dan pendapat saya ialah, you know, if the government does not change for the betterment of people, we need to change the government. Hi, I'm Yiwei, Lim Yiwei, a candidate for Kerusi Dun Selangor and 35 Kampung Tungku. My hashtag, if you see me on the street and take a photo of me, is Yiwei for Kampung Tungku. And like and follow my Facebook page. Hey. Vote for me.